there's hope for me. Whiplash is written and directed by Damien Chazelle and stars Miles Teller, J.K. Simmons, Paul Reiser, and Melissa Benoist. And Whiplash is about a 19-year-old jazz drummer named Andrew Neiman who wants nothing less than to be the best jazz drummer of all time. So he enters supposedly the best music school in the country, the Schaefer Conservatory of Music, if I'm not mistaken, where he becomes the student of the school's most respected and feared teacher, Terrence Fletcher, played by J.K. Simmons. But the way Fletcher teaches his students is so abusive, to the borderline of violent, that it really kind of pushes Miles Teller's character near the edge, but because of his drive and persistence, it really just puts him on this collision course with Fletcher. Now, I was extremely excited to see Whiplash. I heard so many good things of it coming out of Sundance, and you know, it's had tons of Oscar buzz already at this point, but I really had to hunt it down here because in this country, you know, these kinds of movies aren't really that popular amongst Filipinos. So like on the movies like Fourth Day, it's being pulled out everywhere. So I really had to hunt it down, but I was finally able to watch it. And I have to say that Whiplash is the best movie I've seen this year, bar none. It's just filled with such great stuff. It's fantastic performances from the actors, incredible music, and just perfect blend of direction with cinematography and editing. This movie is the whole real deal. First of all, let's talk about how this movie looks. It looks incredible. The colors in this movie are just so vivid and clear, and overall the movie is lighted very well. However, what these things do for the movie is that it makes the movie feel more like a thriller, actually. And the best way I can describe it is, if you've seen Gone Girl, this movie looks a lot like that. It looks a lot like a David Fincher movie. And, you know, it for good reason also, because this movie can be as cold and as clinical as, you know, Gone Girl and stuff like that. You'll also get a ton of really claustrophobic close-ups in this movie that really kind of just show you how difficult jazz is and how personal playing an instrument can be, because you get like so many nitty-gritty details, like, you know, the blood coming out of someone's blisters, or, you know, just the sweat pouring down their faces. And, you know, a lot of this movie also is just framed so well and so precise, because, like, in jazz also you have to be super precise, and this movie is very kind of obsessive compulsive about the little details, so it really helps. There are also like particular moments where the camera would just keep moving, and you know, like trying to keep up with Andrew's drumming. Or there's a certain scene where the camera just kind of swivels between Andrew and Fletcher, and you know, it gave off this really interesting effect. And it's very, very interesting the way this movie is filmed. And if there's one category where a lot of people are saying that, you know, this has to get a nomination sometime, is editing, because this movie is edited so pristinely, especially the music scenes. They have such kinetic energy behind them, but at the same time, they still keep in time with the music. And it just really shows how complex jazz is, because the way this movie is edited, it really just shows all the different instruments playing. And when you see these instruments, you as a viewer begin to hear all the little, you know, complexities of jazz. There's also lots of great visual storytelling in this movie. You know, there are lots of scenes where nothing is said, but we're just shown things that really just resonate with emotion. And there are small things, like, let's say, the looks people give each other, and the way they're inserted into scenes just really kind of speak volumes. And this movie overall really is paced like a thriller. And what I mean by this is that, you know, the tension just really doesn't let up. You know, this movie just throws things at these characters and they just keep on going. And it gets so tense, like every time we see drumsticks. Now, what's interesting about the music here, the jazz music, is that jazz in its very nature sounds very triumphant. It's very catchy, definitely, but it's interesting how this catchiness contrasts with how painful and violent playing it can be. And this really does reflect one of the central questions of this movie of, you know, how far are you willing to go to achieve victory? And so when you hear the jazz music, it's like, you know, this music that the musicians are producing is very, very uplifting in a way. It's very upbeat. But you can see the musicians playing it, and they're just so defeated, and they look so broken. So it's a really interesting effect it gives off. And I just have to note that, you know, if you don't really know a lot about jazz like me, the songs they play in this movie, like Whiplash and Caravan and all that stuff, they're actually real songs. So I didn't know that, and, you know, they're damn good songs. Now, in terms of like the sound mixing in this movie, I'm not really sure whether they recorded the sound live. They probably didn't do it all live, but you know, the way it comes off in the movie in the final product, it's very polished, so you really can hear every sound that goes on. One aspect a lot of people don't really touch on that much in this movie is the plot, and I actually think the plot is very, very well done because it does have a couple of really devastating twists that really push these characters just closer and closer to the edge, and at the same time, it really just, you know, bottlenecks them closer to each other. And it really is ultimately a story about these two nemeses who both want greatness. And it's interesting to see where this movie takes them and how they interact with each other. But this movie really is all about its two central characters, and both Andrew and Fletcher are both extremely flawed people, but they're both extremely dedicated. So, you know, they're not completely likable, but you really, I think, in my opinion, understand where they come from. And you can't really tell what they'll do next, and that's really a mark of a great character. You know, all their actions stay consistent with their characters, but you don't know what they're going to do next. And the things they do to each other, it's crazy because at times they can become extremely cruel, extremely harsh, and very calculating. And like I mentioned a while ago, like the main theme of this movie, in my opinion, really is about, you know, greatness, but at what price, you know? And the way this movie ends also, I think they never really answer that question. They leave it open to interpretation. It's very ambiguous, but it's not a cop-out, you know? You really can talk about this movie a lot and debate about it. And I know this may cause some controversy, especially among teachers, but, you know, I don't really think this is the kind of movie that you have to recognize that it's not giving you an answer. And let's talk about the acting. First of all, Miles Teller, did not know he could have been this great because he is spectacular. When he's not on the drums in this movie, he plays Andrew like really awkwardly, like a robot, almost like Jesse Eisenberg played Mark Zuckerberg in The Social Network. But when he gets onto the drums, he becomes this force of nature, really. Like you can kind of feel like when he's not on the drums, he's just trying to. He doesn't know what to do with himself, so when he gets on the drums, it just comes out, and you know, a million different things are just happening on his face when he's playing the drums, because you can tell he's, you know, concentrating on the music, he's trying to push himself, he's trying to stop himself from giving up, he's trying to rebel against Fletcher. All these different things are happening. You can just see it in how tortured his expressions are. J.K. Simmons in this movie, he's a bit funny at first. Like, there were some people in my theater who were laughing a bit during his first outburst, but eventually, pretty soon, he becomes really, really terrifying with no hint of irony in it. And what's great is that he does kind of ride that line of being funny and really terrifying at the same time. And just the way he plays Fletcher, it's so precise. Like, his movements are just so precise, and the things he says, like, he doesn't kind of fumble when he's trying to insult somebody. He's just, you know, he's so hard-hitting, he's just so single-minded. And, you know, just his gestures when he's conducting and stuff, you can really tell, like, he knows what he's doing. And this movie really, really, really shines when these two are on screen together because, you know, the relationship between the two really just grows increasingly more complex. And because of how this movie kind of ends ambiguously, again, you could debate about, you know, where they are at the end of the movie, but, you know, it's just interesting to see what these two enemies can do for each other. The supporting cast is all good, they all do good jobs, but, you know, there's no denying that this is the Miles Teller and J.K. Simmons show. And as a director, Damien Chazelle really directs the music scenes with such unflinching passion. You know, it's clear to the viewer that this guy has a lot of respect for jazz and music, and he really just does not stop in showing us both the pain and pleasure of playing jazz. And it really is such a true achievement for someone to make this kind of movie more of a psychological thriller than it is like an inspirational film of sorts. And you know, I wouldn't really say it's an inspirational movie. It's really more of an electric movie. You know, it just really pumps you up. What's crazy is that when you do some research, you find out that Damien Chazelle and his crew only had 19 days to shoot this, and it only proves how singular his vision was. Because, you know, in 19 days, it's so tough to film all these different things, but, you know, he's just so precise also, and he knows exactly what had to go into each shot. Whiplash is an amazing film, and I really, really think it's going to get tons of Oscar buzz. I mean, not just buzz, but nominations and stuff. I really hope so. I'm hoping it doesn't end up like Fruitvale Station last year. And just a side note, I forgot to mention also that Whiplash actually is a product of a short film that Damien Chazelle also wrote and directed last year. It also won big at Sundance. It starred J.K. Simmons, but instead of Miles Teller, it had Johnny Simmons, who played young Neil from Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. But anyway, I can't find that short film online. If someone can find a copy or anything, I'd love to see it. But how about you guys? Did you see Whiplash? What did you think about it? Did you love it? Did you hate it? Whatever you thought. Whether you agree with me or not, please leave me a comment. Let's have a conversation.